The full Windsor is pretty much dead. Nobody wears the full Windsor anymore. That's that big, like triangular size knot. This here is a thinner tie, so it's 2 3/4 from side to side. And on a thinner tie, I prefer to use a type of knot that's called a half Windsor. So what I do is I start with the smaller side on the left, the bigger side on the right, fold the bigger side right over left, and then just take my right finger and pinch that little portion right there. Take the big side underneath and over, just let it drop easily. And just kind of smooth out this little underside of the knot and make a really nice tight knot right there. Then what you'll do is you'll take this portion of the tie and you'll fold it underneath and over. And so you've basically made just a big circle around right there. And again, kind of pull it so it's nice and clean. This is where people run into problems. If you don't get this part clean, it's not going to ultimately work. And so now you've got the bigger side here, and then you can go back up under and then let it drop right there in front. And once it drops, you'll just take the big portion, pull it back, and feed it nicely through the tie. A lot of guys like that little dimple in their tie right now. It's very in vogue right now. Based on the material of the tie, you can or can't get it, but it's at this last portion right there, you would kind of crease it as you're pulling it down. And you'll take the tie and pull it up so it's nice and snug. And this is actually perfect. Not bad. I'm impressed with how it turned out. The half Windsor is the style of the knot that I just showed you. And what you'll notice is that it's not supposed to be perfectly square across the top. It should have almost like a little bit of an angle to it. And then flip it over right here. And this is a nice thickness for a tie that's more on the trimmer side right there.